what is experience capitalization and is it really necessary?
Experience capitalization, as the word says, you capitalize on your experience. It means now you're reflecting at what you have been doing in the past so that you add value and you gain new knowledge for the future.
Okay, so but often people say they don't have the time for that activity.
Indeed, people say they don't have the time. However, if you don't take the time to capitalize on the past, you're going to waste your time because you don't learn from your mistakes and you don't know how you get your success. And so you're reinventing the wheel.
I understand about the time now, but what about resources? You know, people always say they don't have the resources.
People say they don't have the resources because they think that they have to hire an external consultant to do the work. But it is not an external consultant work. It is something that the stakeholders are going to do themselves because it's a participatory process. It is their own experience. So they are learning themselves about what they have done so that they can plan better for the future. And therefore, it's important to plan this, to know that you're going to have workshops at a certain moment of your project life.
So you can allocate the money.
So that you can allocate the money and you know who will come when.
I understand about time, resources, but what about skills? People say they don't have the skills to do that.
They have the skills because really? It is a natural practice. You learn from your mistake every day. It's just that you don't say. You learn for yourself. Here, what we try to do is that you do it with the people you work in. So you do this more systematically.
Better, you learn to do it better.
Yes, you learn on a regular basis how to do it better. You don't wait until the end. You actually do this on a regular basis.
So maybe you can build on the skills you have within your teams also.
Yes, indeed, because in each of your team you have different people, whoever you can have a facilitator, you have someone who is better in the monitoring and evaluation, you have someone who is communication. So you're using all the skills that is in the team.
Okay, so it's not that
No.
Okay, so it's not that complicated, but how do you really do it then?
You don't need to make it complicated. You can really start small. Okay. And also, we have tools to help you.
Right.
For example, we have a template that enables to collect your experience,
okay,
asking plenty of questions, and this is a good way to start. Mm-hmm. And also, we have developed now a learning module.
Oh, really?
Yes, this will be e-learning course, but also notes for the learners, mm-hmm, and material for the people who are going to be training workshops.
Okay.
So it will be blended learning.
Okay.
So that's how it can be done.